Welcome to the Office of the Westchester County Clerk's Property Records Electronic Portal, or PREP System, tutorial series. And also welcome on behalf of Westchester County Clerk Tim Idoni. Today's PREP tutorial will cover the basic elements of the PREP system, including creating an account, making changes to your account, assigning packages to another PREP user, adding payments, and printing and submitting documents. To begin, navigate to the PREP system at prep.westchesterclerk.com. The first time you use the PREP system, you will need to create a free PREP account to identify yourself as the submitter when entering documents for recording. To create your account, click the Create Account link below the Username and Password fields. On the next screen, you will need to create a username and password for your PREP account, and then enter some basic contact information about yourself. If ever you forget your PREP password, we will ask for the answer to your security question to verify your identity when resetting your password. If you would like cover pages to display the company you work for as the submitter, enter the company name in the account name field. If you prefer that you be identified as the submitter on your cover pages, you can leave the account name field blank and PREP will instead display your name as the submitter. At the bottom of the page, you are required to check the box acknowledging compliance with the New York State Identity Theft Law. If you would like to allow other PREP users to transfer transactions to your PREP account, you can check the box to accept assignment of packages. If you're unsure about acceptance of packages from others, you can change this selection, as well as any other information on this page, at a later time. Now click Create Account when you have completed all the information on this page, and a confirmation message will be displayed, with a link to return to the login screen. Now that you've created your PREP ID, you can enter the ID and password into the appropriate fields, and then click Sign In or press Enter to enter the PREP system. You can now start entering documents by clicking Creating a Package to start your first transaction. To learn more about creating packages and entering specific documents, please visit our other tutorials. In this lesson, we're simply learning some of the basics of the PREP system. One of the most basic elements of the PREP system is the helpline. If ever you need assistance with PREP, please call the helpline at 914-995-3111 between the hours of 8 a.m. and 5 p.m. weekdays. Now that you've created your account, you can change any of the account details other than the username by clicking My Account at the top of the screen. On the My Account screen, you can make changes to any of the information you entered when you created your account, and then click Update to save the changes. If you have any pending transactions that have not yet been submitted in your account, the system will ask whether you want your updated account information reflected on the cover pages you've already created. Any packages that you do not update will retain the prior contact information on the cover pages. On the left side of the My Account screen, you will see that there are buttons to change your password, create, join, or manage a user group, assign packages to another PREP user, change your user preferences, and access financial functions such as adding guarantee letters, administering ACH accounts, and applying for refunds. The most commonly used of these functions is the Assign Packages function, which you can reach by clicking Assign Packages on the left-hand side. On the Assign Packages screen, click the name of the package you want to assign, and then click the right arrows to move the package from the Current Packages box to the Packages to be Assigned box. You can continue highlighting packages and clicking the right arrows to move multiple packages to the box to be assigned, if you intend to transfer multiple transactions to another user. Next, you can type part of the name of the person or user ID to whom you would like to transfer the package or packages and click Search. To transfer this package to Generic Title Company, you can type the word generic into the search field and three user IDs are found. To assign the package to John Q. Public, simply click Assign on the line with his ID and then click Yes to assign the package. Now, when we click the My Packages at the top of the screen, you can see that the package we assigned is no longer available because it has been transferred to the John Q. Public account at Generic Title Company. Assignment of packages is typically done when one user begins the data entry of the package, but another user is going to finish and submit the package at the closing. Once you have fully entered the information to create all the cover pages in your package, You can click Pay to create a payment cover page, telling us how you're paying the fees and taxes associated with your package. On the payment screen, you will see your fees, mortgage taxes, and transfer taxes itemized in three columns. You must enter a separate payment for each of the three categories. Start by choosing fees as your payment purpose, and choose a payment type to pay the recording fees. If you select a check or money order as your payment type, you will be required to enter a check number. If you do not know the check number, you can enter 0 in the check number field. If you're using a guaranteed check, you must then select the guarantor link to choose from the guarantors you have on file with this office. If you have set up an ACH account or accounts with this office, you can select ACH as your payment type, and then choose which ACH account to draw from using the drop-down list below. If you choose to use a credit card to pay recording fees, you must then click Process at the end of the credit card line to enter the credit card information. Once you've entered the payment type, purpose, and amount, click Add Payment to move the payment information into the grid. After entering a payment for fees, the only outstanding payment is for mortgage taxes, so the Purpose field automatically switches to Mortgage Tax, and the Amount field fills with the mortgage tax amount. We can now choose our payment type and click Add Payment to move the information to the grid. Once all the total amounts due are 0, we can click Return to Package Details to return to the My Packages screen. The only step remaining is to click Print and print your cover pages and tax forms, if any. In the Print pop-up, you can check the boxes next to any documents you want to print and then click Print, or you can simply click Print All without the need to check any boxes. The cover pages will open as a PDF, which you can then send to the printer and save for your records if you like. You can now close the cover pages and click Submit to transmit the data to our office, where it will be matched to the physical documents when they are received. If you are registered for e-recording, instead of printing the cover pages, you would have scanned and uploaded your documents, and when you clicked Submit, the documents would immediately be received by this office and would enter the examination queue for processing. Thank you for watching this prep tutorial. Please visit us online and check out our other tutorials at www.westchesterclerk.com or youtube.com/thewestchesterclerk or facebook.com/westchestercountyclerk or follow us on Twitter at westctyclerk. Thank you, and join us again.